Hi, I'm Chad with Mastercam, and in this video, we're going to create a multi-axis finishing toolpath using Mastercam's automatic tool tilt feature. At this point in the process, most of the part is already finished machined. However, the faces shown in orange on the model still need to be completed. This feature can be very difficult to reach inside of, especially considering that the machine this part will be cut on can only safely tip up to 105 degrees with this fixture on the table. To finish machine such a complex shape, I prefer to start with the Morph toolpath. I'll select my from and to curves first, followed by my drive surfaces. Selecting the drive surfaces is simple. I can launch the color quick mask, and using the selection arrow, I'll click one of the orange faces. Mastercam automatically selects all the other faces that are the same color. Using tools like Change Face under Model Prep to color code the various regions and features on your part is a great habit to get into. Not only can it make visualizing your programming workflow easier, but it really streamlines geometry selection when creating a toolpath. Since this is a finishing toolpath, I'll decrease the step over to 10 thousandths. I'll also deactivate the collision control checkbox for now. When programming complex multi-axis parts, it's always a good idea to leave tool axis control set at the defaults. It's also good to make sure that collision control is turned off at this point as well. There are two reasons for this. Firstly, the only thing you should be concerned with at this point is the actual feed moves. With collision control turned on, Mastercam is going to trim or otherwise modify the toolpath anytime the tool collides with the part. That's going to make it much harder or even impossible to accurately understand what the cut pattern is doing. Secondly, the regeneration time of the toolpath will be shorter, which means you can work faster when getting the cut pattern configured. In this case, the feed moves look great. The pattern is even across the surface, which will produce a nice finish. If the feed moves weren't clean, I could refine the settings on the cut pattern page until the motion was the way I wanted it. Since the feed moves are good, I'll review the toolpath in backplot to get an idea of how the tool motion itself looks. The default tool axis control is keeping the tool normal to the drive surface, which won't work for this toolpath. At this point, I'm going to start working with the tool axis control settings to try and eliminate or at least minimize as many of the collisions as possible. I'm also going to use the simplest strategy possible with the goal of keeping rotary motion to a minimum to maximize rigidity. This is going to help with surface finish when using tools like this lollipop. On the tool axis control page, I'll change the strategy to fixed angle to axis. Looking at the gnomon in the lower left of the graphics window, I can tell that I need to set the tilt angle axis to be X. I'll also set the angle to 180 degrees since I'm cutting on the left side of the part. Looking at the regenerated toolpath in backplot, it almost looks like a traditional three-axis toolpath. There are still clearly collisions happening, so now it's time to activate collision control. I only want to collision check the shoulder, shank, and holder. For a strategy, I'll choose Tilt Tool and Automatic. I'll now add some check surfaces. Just like I did with the drive surfaces earlier, I'll use the color quick mask to select the green faces that I want to avoid. Let's stop for a second and cover a few concepts to keep in mind when using collision control. For this operation, the check surfaces that I've selected are not the same surfaces as the ones I want to machine. So I've turned off flute. Here's why. Since I already know the flute is cutting my machining surfaces the way I want, and my strategy is set to tilt, collision control may add unwanted motion to the toolpath where the machining and check surfaces meet. Additionally, if I didn't turn off flute and my stock to leave value is greater than zero, I wouldn't be able to cut the entire machining surface. This is because the additional stock to leave on the check surfaces would overlap onto the machining surfaces, keeping the tool from cutting up to the point where these surfaces meet. Lastly, turning off collision checking for things we don't need to worry about will also speed up the regeneration time of the toolpath. So now let's look at a situation where the check and machining surfaces are the same. In this configuration, I would want to enable the checkbox for the flute. I would set the stock to leave value to zero, which would drive the flute of the tool directly on the machining surfaces. The additional clearance values for the shoulder, shank, and holder will be added as offsets to that stock to leave value. With these concepts in mind, let's go back to the part file and finish setting up collision control. I'm going to uncheck Extend Tool to Infinity to help improve the tool control in the undercut areas at the top of the feature. Since I have some undercutting happening, I also want to use a lead-in and a lead-out. On the default lead-in, lead-out page, I'll enter 30% as the lead arc diameter and regenerate the toolpath one last time. Since I know there are rotary axis limitations due to my fixturing, I'm going to set up machine simulation to match the machine I'll be cutting on and check for any issues. I'll choose my fixture from level 500 and launch simulation. The motion looks smooth, there are no machine collisions, and note how efficient the tilting motion is. I hope this video has shown you not only the power and flexibility of automatic tilt, but also helped you with some core concepts when programming a multi-axis part in Mastercam.